Well, the creative vision that came from RTP, which is my client and who I work for, was something that had a strong national identity and that was versatile enough to create 43 different unique looks for all the songs.
The basic idea was to find something which is really close to the narrative of Portugal and Lisbon and the sea and all the themes which are important for the producers.
It was a creative decision which origins from the last year's winner. He stood on stage in Kiev and he claimed that music is not fireworks. Music should be in focus. And what we discovered was that we have an amazing contrast and a fantastic depth and dynamic in all shots because there is no huge video wall washing it all out.
That was exactly what we tried to achieve. There's several layers to play small scenes, to play big scenes, and to be able to create a kind of architectural lighting approach or to define different spaces in different sizes.
We had to inform all the delegations that there is no video, you have to come up with something else to make your 3 minutes unique. And oh boy, did they go for that challenge. We have so many props this year, it's not even funny. The relationship between Eurovision and Klaipaki, it was originally based on that they have very good creative products that are lightweight, high output, and they don't break.
It was clear that we need some more tools on the lighting side to fulfill the needs of the variation of our show like this.
The more fixtures we have from the same manufacturer, the easier it is to do a show on this scale. We have 2,600 lights in this show.
We ended up with 21 or 22 different fixture types, but in general, we are always looking for workhorses who are able to do more than one thing. So if I have something like just a beam lamp, that would not really fit to our basket. So that I'm quite happy with the Hippicos, which is a good beam lamp and a good wash light, or the Unico, which is a good fixture for a lot of things to work on. And also with the new Arc Score, which we used the first time as our main key lights parallel to the follow spots.
The technical support from Klaipaki has been very good. On a show of this size, when you have these many fixtures running for so many hours, of course you're going to experience problems. So we're depending on full support from the supplier to get new heat shields and bulbs or whatever it might be that breaks during 18 hours of operation every day. And Klaipaki has been very, very good with that. My favorite part is, of course, when we come into the show week, when we are executing all the dress rehearsals and the broadcast, because that's the end of the line, and that's where you get your reward of all the hard work you put in for so long to see it come alive on television.
I would like to make a big bow for my crew. I never could do it alone, and we are here all together, we are 9 people. And I have to say thank you for the last 2 months.
I can't recall a Eurovision production where I've been laughing so much as this one. It's been a pleasure being here.